So we have already gone over one no-gi choke from the back, and now we're going to go over a gi choke from the back. We're going to go over the single wing choke from the back here with my student Tyson. Let's take a look. So from here, I'm starting on Tyson's back. I already have the hooks in, which give me the control that I'm looking for. And let's talk about the grips really quickly. So as I already explained, when we're doing the seatbelt grips, we have one arm going underneath his shoulder and one going over the shoulder. Now, I also want to talk really quickly about the grips. The bottom hand is going to grip that lapel on the same side. So my left hand grips the lapel on his and my left side. As I do that, my right hand comes over here and grabs my own wrist to start off with the control. Next step, I'm going to take my left hand, the one that's on bottom, and I'm going to open that lapel up and I'm going to feed it to my right hand. My right hand is going to go thumb inside the collar and reach back as far as I possibly can. As it's reaching back, my left hand is feeding this lapel down. I'm going to loosen this a bit for Tyson as I demonstrate the technique, but in reality, this should be feeding down really tightly. So I'll loosen it for you here. Now, my left hand is going to reach up to the bending part of the arm inside the bicep, and palm facing me, it's going to go behind my partner's head. My left hand is not going to grip anything, but it's going to push my partner's head forward into the choke. My right hand, keeping a powerful grip, as my left hand pushes forward, my right hand leans back like this. You can see I loosened the choke for my partner. In reality, you would not do that. So here's how it would look. Seatbelt, feed the lapel over, take the left hand, reach up, palm behind the head, push his head forward, and my partner has tapped already. A very powerful gi choke from the back, single wing from the back. I hope you enjoy this technique. Oh,